This interactive simulation models an ideal nozzle or an ideal diffuser. In this case, we fix the outlet pressure, P2. We fix the inlet temperature, and then we can change the inlet velocity with this slider. And we can change the outlet diameter with this slider. And the idea is then we can solve mass balances, energy balances. This is for ideal gas, compressible fluid. And calculate the outlet velocity, outlet temperature, and the inlet pressure. Here we're looking at the case of nozzle, meaning the outlet diameter is smaller than the inlet diameter. So for the case where a small outlet diameter and a high velocity, notice that the velocity increases significantly, and correspondingly, because the kinetic energy is higher, than the enthalpy and the temperature is lower, and there's a significant pressure drop for this to be accomplished, to have this high flow rate and this small diameter. If we make the outlet diameter larger than the inlet diameter is fixed in this simulation. So if we make the outlet diameter larger, then this becomes a diffuser when the outlet diameter is larger than the inlet diameter. And in the diffuser, the temperature will increase slightly. The pressure will increase, or the way of looking at it is this inlet pressure will be lower than 101.3 since that's fixed. And the outlet velocity will be lower than the inlet velocity because we have much bigger diameter. So this simulation assumes no heat transfer, and again assumes ideal and subsonic flow. So all the conditions are such the velocity does not get to a sonic velocity. So let's look at the interactive simulation. So here we're looking at the interactive simulation, and we're at a condition where it's a nozzle, meaning the outlet diameter is smaller than the inlet diameter. And so notice the velocity increases, so we have more kinetic energy, and correspondingly the temperature decreases slightly, and the pressure decreases. Again, slight change in pressure. And in the simulation, the outlet pressure is fixed. And so as I change the inlet velocity, for example, now it takes a higher pressure and more temperature decrease. And then, of course, higher outlet velocity. So this is a nozzle, so let's look at, if I change the diameter, now the velocity changes much smaller, the temperature changes much smaller, and I'll get to the point where these are equal, straight tube, but then nothing is happening. If I have the outlet diameter larger, the diffuser, now the velocity is lower, the temperature is slightly higher, and notice the pressure is slightly higher. We fix the outlet pressure, that means we calculate the inlet pressure to give these values. This is the diffuser when the outlet diameter is larger. We can also look at plots. The dot shows where we are in the system, on the plot, excuse me. In other words, as I change the outlet diameter, I move from the case where we have a diffuser to the case where we have a nozzle. I increase the inlet velocity, and you can see there's a bigger temperature difference for the nozzle. And also on this plot, we're showing incompressible flow. The diagram here is compressible flow, but we're also showing what happened if we had incompressible flow. And then likewise, we're showing velocity on this plot. So the idea of this simulation is to get a little better physical feeling for what happens in a nozzle and a diffuser, and what's the difference between the two as we solve the energy balance, mass balances for a reversible. This is an ideal nozzle or ideal diffuser.